Up on the hospital rooftop, another urgent case is arriving at emergency. An air ambulance is landing with a young man badly injured in a car crash during cold and wet weather.
Is it really cold in here today?
It's freezing. I've had to put extra gowns on.
Senior emergency doctor Jonathan Papson is standing by with his trauma team.
Sounds like he's gone surfing, he's come back in the rain. Someone's just pulled out ahead of him and he's crashed into the side of them. He's been trapped in his car. He's been stuck in there for half an hour.
Usually when it comes via helicopter, it's pretty serious. It's a serious deal.
Oh, here we go.
24-year-old uni student Taylor was pinned in his crashed van in freezing conditions and is in a lot of pain.
We're going to move across and have a look at you, mate. All right? Mm-hmm. You feeling OK?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, been better.
One, two, three. Right, one, two, three.
So Taylor's normally well, driving a high ace van. T-boned a car that cut in front of him. He's got full recollection of the event. He was trapped for about 40 minutes. The first ambulance crew arrived, so he was sort of spread eagle over the top of the steering wheel with his chest resting on it. There is some damage to the steering wheel as well.
Okay. All right.
Injury-wise, is apart from a little bit of bleeding from his nose, there's no obvious injury to his face, to his head.
Yep.
Neck's got no pain.
It's got the wound on the leg.
Is an injury in there, which looks like a bit of dashboard's gone in and out again. And just a steady ooze of blood coming out of it. He has a little bit cold because it was quite cold.
Yeah, cold and wet.
Taylor's very lucky. A lot of people wouldn't survive this sort of crash, especially with the country road, high speed, wet conditions, older car. You know, roll the dice.
Taylor's father arrived at the crash site as his son was being cut from the van. His parents are on their way.
Does that hurt?
No.
Did you hit the steering wheel with your chest?
Oh, I'd assume the airbag didn't go off. So.
You had a seatbelt on?
Yeah.
Does it hurt when you breathe?
No.
No. Did you hit your face on something?
Probably the steering wheel.
With no other obvious external injuries, Dr. Jonathan turns his attention to Taylor's leg, which had been bent up against and then pierced by the dashboard of his crashed van.
So it's probably broken, isn't it? A little bit of ooze coming out.
Is that sore, mate?
No.
Looks like an open fracture bleeding.
So an open fracture is where the fractured bone is exposed to the environment, which means it's just going to get infected unless you do something about it. And it's a bad thing to happen.
The injury is potentially devastating for Taylor, who works as a surf coach and has important uni exams coming up.
And your leg's quite sore, yeah?
Yeah, both of them.
Yeah, both.
What about those toes? Yeah. Well, yeah, that's my big toe.
The toe's
really sore. And the next one.
Both toes numb? Both feet? Or one?
These are sore. Those are kind of numb.
Does that hurt?
For something like this, what are the real problems going to be? It's going to be chances of infection. Is there a problem with the blood supply to the toes? Has the main artery down there been compromised by the fracture, by the bones moving?
So the fast is looking normal. And the chest looks normal.
If it's an open fracture, which means he's got bone poking out, then there's always a potential amputation. So there's always a potential that he's going to lose his leg. That's the real deal here.
The X-ray results are ready and confirm Dr. Jonathan's suspicions.
So he's got a fractured shaft of the tibia, which is not a good injury to have. Because it's open to the environment, you can get an infection from there. So it's actually quite a serious injury to have. If it gets infected, that's big trouble.
It's a broken bone under there.
Yeah, right.
And you can tell because you see how the blood's like a little bit fatty?
Mm.
It's probably coming from the middle of the bone because it's got marrow.
Jonathan calls in specialist orthopaedic surgeon Dr. Patrick Elias to see what can be done to save Taylor's leg.
Looks like it's open, so it's a grade one. Mm. This is a pretty significant injury, and the complications associated with this can be limb-threatening, so we need to do an operation on this as soon as we can and insert a metal rod down the bone and use some screws to secure that rod.
we're giving him antibiotics, we're going to wash it out, but there's still a high chance this thing, this leg of his is going to get infected.
Just a wave request?
No. Taylor's parents, Maury and Joelle, have arrived to see their son.
So you guys just give us heart attacks, you do? Which one? You and your brothers?
Taylor phoned his dad while he was still trapped in the van.
I was doing some gardening and the phone rang and Taylor just said, "Dad, I've had a bad accident and I think I've broken both my legs." And I said to him, "Call an ambulance." And he said, "Oh, we already have." And then he told me where he was. So I said, "I'm on the way." Driving down there, I tried to ring him back and he didn't answer his phone. That's where I was thinking something terrible's happened. I got down there and, you know, there were police and ambulance, everybody all around the place. And the car was just absolutely written off. He was pinned, his legs were pinned in the van and it took them a while to cut him out. They had to obviously cut the van and that. And he was in a fair bit of pain. It was cold, it was raining, it was just a shocking day.
People lose their legs all the time in crashes like that. I've seen the van, he could lose his leg. We will do everything we can to make sure that doesn't happen.
Any questions about that?
Orthopaedic registrar Dr. Timothy Chung prepares Taylor for the major surgery he's facing.
There's some risks involved. Our hope is to give you one operation, some rods, then recovery in about 6 months.
It's overwhelming news for the surf coach and uni student whose life will be dramatically changed by the accident.
So, what are you looking at? Surf coach and student. So you're about 6 months away from being able to surf.
It's going to be awful for him not to be able to do what he loves doing. It's totally unexpected. It's come out of the blue. It might be totally devastating for him. That's his job.
Doctors will need a CT scan of Taylor's broken leg to see the full extent of his injury before he goes to surgery.
He's going to have pins and an external device put on his bones to hold the bones in place. And he's got a wound there that needs to be cared for, and then he's got to worry about all the other things, the tendons and the arteries and the nerves that might have been injured as well. So it's much more complex.
So, I can hold the plaster if you want to get the bandage. So you've got the foot.
Any lower limb injury that's open to the environment, if it gets infected, you lose the leg or you lose part of the leg. That's the real risk. So there's a risk of infection, and even despite antibiotics and the best possible treatment, it can still get infected.
We just have to have it like that because it needs to be in the right spot.
His dad, Maury, is worried about the impact on Taylor, who's studying environmental science and about to sit exams.
There are some memories in my mind, some pictures in my mind that will stay with me forever. You know, just below the vehicle, you know, there was this puddle of oil and blood and rainwater all mixed in, and that was just a horrible thing to see. It'll be no different for Taylor, though. He'll have some horrible memories as well.
Someone's looking after me. I mean, I saw a picture of the car and it's amazing you've still got legs left, to be honest.
Dr. Jonathan has done all he can for Taylor. He's now going to theatre for surgery to try and save his leg. 3.5 months later, the uni student isn't back riding the big waves yet, but he has managed to dip his toes in.
So I went from not being able to take a single step, and then I actually went for my first surf yesterday. So that was pretty exciting.
His leg was saved after marathon surgery, where a titanium rod was inserted from his knee to his ankle.
This experience definitely has changed my outlook on life. I think this accident has strengthened my relationship with my dad. Like, he found it really difficult to be at the accident site and to see me in that situation.
It probably gives us a good outlook on life now. One of the police guys at the thing said to me, you know, someone up there was looking after him, and, you know, we truly believe that.